Alright, been a while since I uploaded, but I've got a really cool video on something you might not expect the Raspberry Pi to do. This tiny computer can do a lot, from running a Plex server, DNS sinkhole, or even playing Minecraft. But what about an FM radio transmitter? There's a repository on GitHub called Pi FM RDS. The Pi and FM part is kind of self-explanatory, but RDS? This is Radio Data System. Basically, you know how the song name and artist show up on your car when you listen to the radio? That's what RDS is. It's a way of encoding some binary text data within an analog FM audio signal. Anyway, how does the Raspberry Pi output a radio signal? It actually uses the GPIO pins. On the Pi, there are a ton of pins that can be used for various things to expand the use of the Pi. I believe it stands for General Purpose Input and Output. It's kind of like a switch that can turn lights on or off, for example. But what if it sent out a little bit of power and turned it on and off super fast? Like really fast. Like 103.1 megahertz fast. Oh wait, that's the frequency of FM radio. So yeah, this is turning off and on a pin super fast to make a signal. It's actually a lot more complex. It has to generate a pilot signal and multiplex the audio, but that's a little over my head. First, let's jump into the installation process. If this is boring to you, which I get, I've timestamped the video so you can skip past it. Really, all you need is that Raspberry Pi and a small wire for the antenna. You'll need the basic stuff like a power supply too and an internet connection just to download the repository.
Okay, so we have a basically fresh install of Raspbian, the OS for Raspberry Pis, and the setup of this is actually pretty simple. The first thing you're going to want to do is do sudo apt install and then do libsnd file1-dev, which this is just a dependency that it has. I'm not exactly sure what it does, but it says it depends on the snd file library, so we're going to install that. I actually already have it installed because of how many times I failed at recording this video, but if you don't, then you're going to want to follow all the prompts and just go through it. It's really simple. It also says you're going to need a new Linux kernel or a newer one, which that definition of new is August 2015 or newer, so you're probably fine because you shouldn't be running an 8-year-old outdated version. And then we're going to download the actual PI FM RDS source code, so git clone and then paste that link in there. Press enter, it's going to clone that into the PI FM RDS folder. I'm going to change into that. And then if you do ls, you can see there's a couple folders here in the readme. You're going to want to do src here. Oh, cd src. Right, and then here's the actual source for it. And it comes with some test sounds and stuff. But the tutorial says to do make clean, which I'll link this tutorial to. But make clean, and then make. It's going to run that. Looks like there's some warnings, but there's no errors. So it's a successful install. And now we can try running sudo pi fm rds. And now if you look here, blah, 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 don't need to worry about this too much. And then pi here is the station ID, and then ps is the like the name of the station. I don't know what varying means. And then rt is the actual text that gets put in alongside the analog signal, and that just gets sent to the radios, and then it starts to transmit on 107.9, which is an actual radio station in my area. I'm obviously not going to overpower that because I don't even have an antenna on this, so I'm not too worried about that. So I'm actually going to clear this out, and I'm going to move over to SSH on here. You can still do everything from within this command shell, but SSH will look better for the video. It looks higher resolution. Okay, so I'm on SSH now, and we're going to go back into that PI FM RDS folder, and one more time into the source. And you can see here, these WAV files in blue are just a lot of test sample sounds that they have, which I'm going to use for now. And then we can load in any WAV file pretty much. Okay, so this is what actually launches Pi FM RDS. And then one thing I want to do is change the frequency off of one that a higher power radio station is going to just overpower me. So we're going to do 103.1 because that's relatively inactive in my area. So we're going to do -free, which is short for frequency, obviously, and then 103.1, and that's good for that. So now if we do that, you can see it says starting to transmit on 103.1 megahertz. I'm gonna cancel that, and then do -audio, because we wanna change what is actually playing. And let's do sound.wave. Here we go. It's a sample sound. If we run that, it would just play the same thing, but using that sound. We're going to do -pi for the station code, which you can put anything. I'm just going to do 4 zeros. It's just so if you wanted to put some numbers there. I don't know what it's really used for. And then -ps is the station name. This is limited to 8 characters, but it's enough to put the name of your station, so your call sign or whatever. We're going to be boring and just put pi fm rds. And then -rt is the actual name of the song or the author, whatever you want to put in there. So we should put wow this works, because if we see it on a radio, then wow, it works. Okay, and then this is our command. Let's run it. It says using audio file sound, and then the input blah blah blah. It's mono audio. Here's that station number we put in, and then the station name, and then the text here, which it looks like I messed up. Okay, there we go. Wow, this works. And starting to transmit on this. So now I'm going to put an antenna on the Raspberry Pi, which is just a little piece of wire. And then I'm going to run out to my car and see if it shows up on this frequency. Okay, so we're going to plug this into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 right here. So 3 down from this side. And let's go to the car. Okay, we're in the car. We're tuned to 103.1 FM. And now we're going to turn it up.
We're using the Raspberry Pi. FM RDS transmitter using the Raspberry Pi. FM RDS transmitter using the Raspberry Pi. FM RDS transmitter.
So it looks like it just loops the same, that sound.wave file or whatever. It just loops that over and over again, but it's technically working. For some reason that text isn't coming through, so I'm going to move it closer to the antenna because it might be really, really weak. Signal. This card picks it up pretty good, but it might be the Raspberry Pi's fault. And I should mention, I had to do this -ppm, which corrects for PPM error. I'll probably cut into this segment and talk about it, and if not, I couldn't figure out what it was.
Alright, so I actually did figure this out. Turns out I did have the PPM set a little off, and that's why I wasn't showing any of the text. I'll show how I fixed that later. For now, let's do the range test. I basically just put the Raspberry Pi on a windowsill at the highest point of my house, and yeah, let's test it. Okay, got some night driving here, that's new. We're gonna drive till this runs out of range. I'm gonna put a little thing at the bottom that shows how far I am from my house. And yeah, let's just go. So yeah, it's pretty quiet. The signal gets pretty weak, pretty close, but really it's not the worst, considering I'm still using that little purple wire, because I don't want it to go that far, which I'll get into later. That's the boring stuff. But yeah, so I don't know if it deserved a full cinematic montage for such a, honestly, uneventful, kind of anticlimactic thing, but I'm going to drive back home now because it's very late. Whoa, jump cut. And now that I'm getting closer, I'll turn back on the volume. You'll hear it fade in and out. There's another radio station that's surprisingly more powerful, even though I couldn't pick it up. The tuners in these cars are really powerful, actually, so yeah, I'll turn it back up. Mastarabacata, So yeah, it worked a lot more than I thought it would, but it's not anything crazy. Still impressive for a Pi. One thing I noticed is that it seems to roll off on the high end, meaning the higher frequencies are quieter. I'm not really sure why it does this.
Anyway, now back to that original issue with PPM and how it wasn't showing the text on the screen. I got some new advancement on this. So I opened up this is a software defined radio. It's basically a USB dongle that is a radio tuner, but I was in the middle of editing and I noticed that on here when I start this up, you can hear it, right? And I didn't really want to go into this detail in this video because I don't really have enough knowledge in this area to explain it. But basically, within this FM signal here, there's what's called MPX, which is multiplexing, which is basically putting like multiple signals on the same wire or on the same frequency. So on here, 103.1. And if you look at this graph, here's mono audio, right? And then here's, this is the pilot signal, and then here's stereo audio, which this is like left and right. And then here's that RDS data, which is the binary data for that station name and song name and all that. So if I press play, yeah, again, there's it's working, right? And I know this is a little complicated. I don't really know what all this is anyway. Up here in this little black segment, there's supposed to be the song info, but it's not showing up on here either. And then I noticed this pilot signal is actually supposed to be on this 19K line, and it's not. And so that comes down to that PPM error thing I was talking about. Basically, all we need to look at is this MPX spectrum down here. And when we do this, you can see the normal command. And you see I did this PPM, blah, 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 and it makes it sound okay. But then if we don't do it at all, it's gonna sound really sluggish. So yeah, that sounded terrible, and there was high-pitched noise, which hopefully I removed for your ears' sake. And then if we go up arrow again, and we do dash PPM, and we do, instead of 1,050,000, let's go, like, let's just add a 1 here. You can see it's running a little bit higher pitch than it should be. And the pilot shifted over more. If we put a 2 here, it's even farther over. So basically, I just did a too high of number, and if I go 1 million on the dot, look at that. Now it's running at the right pitch, and you can see the pilot is right on that 19K line on the graph. And it costs a lot. I'm always at the Guala, yeah, and you are not bad. And if we look up here, that RDS works. So let's go check what the car says.
Okay, we tuned it. Look at that. Wow, this works. That's pretty cool. So, it came down to that PPM thing, and now it's working. There's also the legal aspect of this. It's illegal. There are tons of low power or pirate radio stations you can see all over YouTube, but still, do this at your own risk. This is an experiment, and the fine can be very expensive. I only had this on the air for probably 15 to 30 minutes, and I'm not responsible for you being an idiot. Anyway, that's about it for the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and maybe even learned something. Thanks for watching.